Today I have for you guys a question from the 2003 Australian Mathematics Competition, and only 3% of students got this one right. So the question is, if f of 11 equals 11, and f of n plus 3 equals f of n minus 1 all over f of n plus 1, we have to find f of 2003. So you might like to pause the video here and see if you can figure that out. So with a lot of maths questions, it helps to just sit and think for a while and try to come up with a strategy for approaching it. I don't think this is one of those questions. I think with this one, you just have to charge in and see what happens. So what I would do is just try out using this formula with n equals 11, because we know what f of 11 is. So if we plug in 11 in there, we will get f of 14. So f of 11 is 11. So just applying that formula, we get 10 over 12. And you can simplify that and turn it into 5 over 6. Okay, maybe we can try doing the next one. So we could do f of 17 would be the next one if you plug in n equals 14. So you've got f of 14 there, which is the 5 over 6 that we just found. Now, to deal with that kind of expression where you've got fractions within a fraction, what you want to do is just multiply top and bottom by 6, and that's going to get rid of these fractions within the fraction. So that'll give you 5 minus 6 over 5 plus 6, so negative 1 over 11. Okay, we've got f of 17. Still no idea of a strategy for how to work out f of 2003, but let's just keep going and see what happens. So the next one would be f of 20. We plug in our negative 1 over 11, that minus 1 over negative 1 over 11 plus 1. Again, to get rid of those fractions, you want to multiply top and bottom by 11, which is going to give you negative 1 minus 11 over negative 1 plus 11, which is negative 12 over 10. And we can simplify that. That makes negative 6 over 5. Okay, that's kind of interesting because that's the negative reciprocal of that one. And also, that's the negative reciprocal of the original f of 11 was 11. So let's see what happens with the next number. So we can go up to f of 23, which will be the last one, minus 1 over that plus 1. Again, to get rid of the fractions within the fraction, multiply top and bottom by 5, which is going to give you negative 6 minus 5 over negative 6 plus 5. And then that makes negative 11 over negative 1, which is just positive 11. So we've come back to what f of 11 was. We started out with 11. And that will mean that the next one in the sequence, the f of 26, well, that's just, 11 minus 1 over 11 plus 1 again, just like we had for f of 14. So that's going to be 5 over 6. And then the next one's going to be negative 1 over 11, and then the next one's going to be negative 6 over 5, and so on. It's going to just repeat itself. So what I might do is just write these out in a table. So we had f of 11, f of 14, f of 17, and f of 20. And they were 11, the f of 14 was 5 over 6, then we had negative 1 over 11 and negative 6 over 5. And that's just going to keep repeating. So this is also f of 23, f of 26, f of 29, f of 32, and so on. So we have to work out f of 2003. So here's where you might want to stop and brainstorm strategies for how to do that. So the way that I would tackle it is I would try to work out how many threes have been added to 11 to make 2003. As in, this is one three added, this is two threes added to 11, this is three threes added, and so on. And then the F of 23, which is four threes added, was 11 again. And then you'll have five threes added, six, seven, eight, and so on. And it keeps wrapping around like that. So you'll notice that, like, all the multiples of four give you 11. All the ones that are a multiple of four plus one, they give you five on six, and so on. So if we can work out the number of threes added, first of all, so let's do that. The way that I would work that out is I would do 2003 minus 11, that gives 1992, and then divide that by 3. So 3 into 1992. Not allowed calculators for this competition, so. Okay, so 664. Now, we got to work out where that number goes. Like, is it a multiple of 4, in which case it would go in this column? Is it a multiple of 4 plus 1, in which case it'll be in this column and it'll be 5 on 6, and so on. So to work out whether that's a multiple of 4 or not, you can just look at the last two digits of a number, because 100 is divisible by 4, so we can kind of ignore that bit. So 64 is actually a multiple of 4. It's 16 times 4. So that means it's going to be in this column with all the other multiples of 4, which means that the answer is going to be 11. Now, just to test that out, what I would do is kind of like repeat this process with another number just to check, because it's easy to sort of get off by one. So I might pick like the F of 26, we already know what that is, but I can do exactly the same process that I did here, just to check that that process is correct. So first thing I did was 2003 minus 11, so I'll do 26 minus 11, that makes 15. And then we did that divided by 3, so 15 divided by 3 is 5. And then what I did with that number was I worked out, was it a multiple of 4 or does it have some remainder? So with this 5, that's 1 4 with a remainder of 1. So that would put it in that column, which is correct. So I can see that that process is correct. I'm not off by 1. So I'm pretty confident that 11 is the answer from that. If you have any questions, then leave me a comment below. And give this video a like if you want me to make more like this. Next time in this series, I'll be tackling this question, so stay tuned for that one.